Hi friends, welcome to Kodai Linux. I am your facilitator Murali. As a part of today's session, we are going to learn about the cut command. So cut is also a filter command. So cut is used to retrieve either specified characters or fields from each line of input file. The syntax of cut is cut followed by options if any, followed by file names if any. Cut is also a filter command. So as you know, a filter command when issued without any arguments would read input from the standard input file, that is the keyboard, and send its processed output to the monitor, which is the standard output file. So let us try to understand about the options of the cut command. There is an option called -c option. This -c option is used to extract characters from every line of input file and outputs to the standard file, standard output file. -d option is used to specify delimiter, the delimiter character based on which cut should understand the fields from every line of input file. -f option is used to specify the fields to be retrieved from every line of input file. -- version, when cut command is issued with -- version, it displays version of the cut command. -- help, used to display help message of cut command. With any command, you can specify these two options. Like -- version would display the version of that command, and -- help would display help information about that command. Let us start working on these concepts on the dollar prompt. Let us start working with the cut command. Cut -- version. With this option, we would be able to know the version of the cut command that we are using. To whichever server we have connected, which version of cut command is there in that server, we can know. Not only with cut command, any other command, with any other command also, when you specify -- version option, by specifying this option, you would be able to know the version of the command. Similarly, I want to get help screen, help information about the any particular command. So here we are giving with the cut command. So it will give basic help information about the command. See, it tells about usage of the command. It's like a mini man page. Then now the definition of that command, what that command does, okay, and then the various options and their significance. That is about the -- help option. Next, let us look at the -c option. As we saw, -c option helps us to extract or retrieve characters from every line of the input file. So let me give -c, okay, 5, 8, but I am not giving any file name. In that case, the cut would extract, cut would expect input from the keyboard. So every line I input in the keyboard, it would extract 5th character to 8th character. That is 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. Okay, so Himalayas I have entered. So Laya, it's getting it. Okay. Similarly, excitement, TME, whatever is 5th to 8th characters, it would extract. How do I terminate the cut command? Control D. Rather, if I give cut -c, earlier I gave 5-8. So when I am specifying hyphen between a smaller digit and the higher bigger digit, that is 5-8. It should be smaller, bigger, 5-8. It cannot be the other way around, 8-5, it's not valid. then 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. It refers to the range. But now, if I give 5, 8, then it refers to the list, 5th character and 8th character. Now also let me accept input from the keyboard. Now I have given cut hyphen C 5, 8. Okay. Hilarious. So 5th character is R and 8th character is U. Okay. Culmination. 5th character is I and 8th character is T. So it would extract specified characters. So comma is the to specify the list of characters, but hyphen is to specify the range. So this is with regard to the hyphen C option. So whatever we have done with the input file from the keyboard, we can do with the same any other disk file also. From disk file also, when I want to extract characters or retrieve characters, I can specify the disk file name. Then from each line of input, it would extract that specific characters and output on the monitor. If you want to redirect to a file, you can redirect. If you want to pipe the output to any other command, you can do that also. Next, let us understand about the hyphen D option and the hyphen F option. So what is the purpose of hyphen D option? Let me reiterate. Hyphen D option purpose is to tell cut command, okay, the based on what delimiting character it should understand the piece. This is the purpose of the hyphen D option. What is the purpose of hyphen F option? To tell cut command to retrieve specific fields. That is the purpose of the hyphen F option. We have one file called emp.lst. It has got a set of employee records. Like every employee record has got certain fields. They are employee number, employee name, employee designation, and employee date of joining. Fine. Or you can tell employee date of birth. Employee date of birth. Okay. So these are the fields that are there in the file. Now what if I want to extract, retrieve only from every line of the input file, I want to retrieve only employee name and employee designation. Let us suppose I want to retrieve only these two fields. How do I do that? For that, I need to specify cut followed by hyphen D option to recognize the field delimiting character, to specify the field delimiting character, followed by hyphen F option to tell which fields I need to retrieve. I want to retrieve second field and third field from every line of input file. So 2, 3. I told you that comma is the list character to specify the character, to specify that it is a list. So second field and third field. If I want to specify second field to fourth field, then 2-4. So hyphen is the range, indicates the range. Comma indicates the list. So I want second field and third field. If I want, I can give 2-3 also, second field to third field. So that is not required. So I can give 2, 3, second field and third field from every line from the input file, and followed by the name of the file, that is emp.lst. So by this, what I am telling, based on the delimiting character colon, I want to extract or retrieve second and third field from every line of the input file emp.lst. Does it retrieve second and third field from every line of input file? Yes, it retrieves second and third field. Let us suppose I want to extract first, second and fourth field. Then what do I do? -d: -f first comma, second comma, fourth. 1 comma, 2 comma, 4. EMP dot LST. It will extract first, second and fourth field from every line of the input file. So this is the purpose of the hyphen. So I believe you would have understood about the significance of the hyphen D option and the hyphen F option. Hyphen D option is for specifying the to tell the cut command based on which delimiter it should recognize the fields, and hyphen F option is to indicate which fields it has to retrieve. Next, let us look at one more example. Like I have long listing output of ls command. What if I want to retrieve? So you all know that the significance of every column of output of long listing output of ls. First column refers to the permissions to the file. Second column, number of links to the file. I'll explain you what is the meaning of number of links to the file in a later session when we come to that topic. Then UID of the file, GID of the file, size of the file in bytes, then the date and time of when the file was last modified. Finally, followed by the name of the file. What if I want to retrieve the size of the file and the name of the file? Okay, so this is the first column, second column, third column, fourth column, fifth column is size of the file in bytes. Sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. So I want to extract from every line output by long listing output of ls command. I want to extract fifth column and ninth column. So what I do? Ls hyphen l, and our friend pipe is there. So we'll make use of our friend pipe. So pipe it to cut hyphen d. And what is the delimiting character between every column? It is space, right? And then which columns I want to extract? Fifth column and ninth column. Let us see whether it extracts properly. No, it doesn't extract properly. Why it doesn't extract properly? Because cut will extract exactly the specific fields from every line of input file only if the lines are delimited by exactly one space character. If the delimiting character is space, only one space character. So if there are multiple spaces between any fields, then it would not extract properly. Okay, so if there are multiple spaces between one space and another space, it will infer that there is a null field, so that way it doesn't retrieve properly. So it understands that way. So the prerequisite for cut command to work properly is that the whatever input file is given to it, in that only the field should be separated by only one occurrence of the delimiting character. So from the LS-L output, we should see that if there are any multiple spaces, that should be made to single space. How do we do that? Can we recall something? Earlier we learnt about a command called TR. What does the TR do? There is one option called hyphen S option. With that hyphen S option, what we can do? We can squeeze the multiple consecutive occurrences of a specific field to a single occurrence. So what do we do? Long listing output of ls, we send it to tr, wherein we squeeze multiple occurrences of space. Look at the output of this. So there is now in this output, every line you see, every line of output between the fields, there is only one space. This is what we want. This is the prerequisite for cut command to work. Now let us recall this command sequence, piping sequence. And now send the output of tr command to cut. Now let us again try to cut based on the space delimiter, which fields we want to cut, fifth field and ninth field. Let us see if we are able to extract exactly the size of the file and the name of the file. Yes, from every line of the input file, that is input to the cut command, that is a long listing output, wherein the multiple spaces are squeezed to single space, we are extracting we are able to extract correctly the size of the file and the name of the file. So we are able to achieve this. With this, we are coming to the conclusion of the cut command. If anyone has got any further doubts regarding the cut command, you can ask your doubt in the comment section. If you like this session, you can share it, because sharing is caring. If you are yet to subscribe to our channel, you can subscribe to get updates. Also, remember to click on the bell icon to get notifications. Thank you. See you in the next class. Take care. Bye-bye.